Hi, this is Brandon Smilley from ThirstGym.com. Today we're going to show you the exercise called the Monster Walk. This is a great hip and glute exercise, and you usually see this a lot in warm-ups. By all means, you can use it other places. You can definitely use it as finishers and things like that. But the Monster Walk is great for known in terms of developing the hip strength and trying to help prevent ACL tears and knee issues and hip issues and low back issues. So I really like the Monster Walk. We usually program them in a lot of our athletic training programs, especially for our youth athletes that are females. As they begin to mature and their hips begin to change due to puberty, we want to make sure their hips stay good and strong to prevent ACL and knee issues down the line for those athletes. But also having big, strong hips in terms of athletes usually is great for developing more force, power, and improved speed and performance. So for the Monster Walks, I really like using these small bands preferably. You could obviously use things like hip circles and just take a regular mini band and double it up. But these have worked really well for us. And then in terms of our positioning, we can have these on the knees or the ankles. We used to start with putting them on the knees, and now we've kind of drifted towards more putting them on the ankles. I think it provides some better feedback for the athletes, shortens the learning curve a little bit. But athletes that are a little bit weaker, obviously you bring it up towards the knees, it's not going to be as challenging as it is against the feet. However, with the feet, sometimes you can see the athletes try to focus on the hip flexion portion of it rather than trying to make sure they keep lateral distribution into the band. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the band on. And I'm going to start with my knees first and then go down on my ankles. So we can put it above the knee or below the knee. Honestly, it's going to be a little easier above, a little harder below. I think below it feels better. And then what we're going to do is we're going to get an athletic position, athletic stance. We want to make sure we can feel our whole foot, the knees around my knees. I'm going to take my hip musculature to push the knees out, creating external rotation, and I should feel that into my hips. Okay, and then depending upon which way we're walking, then we take short, choppy steps to the side, and then obviously go the other way, depending upon how you're programming it. But what we want to emphasize is that we take good, short, choppy steps, and we don't want to get a really short to where our feet get within our hip width. Okay, there's nothing really wrong with this, but this isn't very athletic. I mean, it's very easy to fall over. You know, a good wide base of support gives us a good athletic position. Generally, we're doing this with athletes and personal training clients, so we want them to feel that resistance, but also have them a good strong base of support and really challenge their hip musculature. You're going to get more of that out here than you are here, and then obviously however many steps you're going to perform. If you're going to put it down at your feet, it's the exact same thing. We're going to put it out here, and then we're going to take good short choppy steps side to side. Now, I can already tell you, I feel this way more in my feet than I do in my knees. And if you think about it, when I step, my feet are wider than my knees in the other position. So I'm creating more tension on the band. So that's Monster Walks. Very simple. We just want our hip position to be broken. Like I said, in that athletic position, you know, we're not going to be at 90 by any means, but we're probably going to be about 45, maybe even a little higher, just so that we can feel our hip and glute musculature doing vast majority of the work and making sure our knees aren't falling in. We're feeling the lateral and outside part of our foot as we step. So we really program these as part of our warm-up, halfway down one way, halfway back the other direction, and really just to warm the hip musculature up, improve a little bit of strength, and just make sure the athletes know what that good athletic position feels like as the hip musculature is a little stronger. Obviously, you can put it in as finishers as well and work on some lateral movement in your training programs for free while developing a little bit of hip musculature. And with your youth athletes, a lot of times that could be a very, very simple, quick fix to help just build some overall performance benefits while you've got it paired with other things. So Monster Walks, very common exercise. I think putting them in your warm-up is an easy way to help improve performance and obviously help decrease injury risk. So if you've got any questions, feel free in the comment section. Thanks. Have a great day.